Today we will talk about how to make this cold transition. I have a video in timeline that I want to make speed ramp transition in it. First of all, make sure you cut your video in the middle. Then we want to expand our track. There is two ways you can expand your track. The first way, click in this timeline display settings and click expand all tracks. That will expand your tracks. Or second thing, you can click in this track, the specific track you want to expand it, then press Alt from your keyboard and scroll. That will expand your track. First step to make our speed ramp, to make right click and show clip keyframes and time remapping, then choose speed. That will appear this line. Make the same thing with the second part of your clip, show clip keyframes and time remapping speed. Then select your pen tool from here, or from selecting P from your keyboard, you can make this so our speed will start from this point. Make the same thing with another clip. Make sure you have enough time, like 4 seconds or 3 seconds at least, to make this speed ramp. So click V to bring up your selection tool, or go here and select it. Then move this line above, something like this, and make the same thing with another clip, like that. Then you can move this right to make this smooth transition between your normal speed and this high speed clip. You can change the circle to make this graph more smooth, like that, and make the same thing with another clip. Then you must trim your clip at the beginning of your speed here, like that, and same thing here. Bring this clip here, and we can see the transition here. That's cool. We can add some directional blur here that makes our transition more professional. You can make right click here and new item adjustment layer that fits our sequence. So put it here at the beginning of the speed and here, like that, and go to effects panel. From here, if you miss it here, you can go to the window and you will find it here, effects. So you can write directional blur, drag it in your adjustment layer, and we can make 3 keyframes. First at the beginning of adjustment layer, and the same keyframe at the end of adjustment layer, at the middle of adjustment layer, or between our clips here. You can increase the blur. Then you can change the direction of the blur according to your video. I will decrease the blur a little bit, and we can see here. I see the blur is too much, so I will decrease it. Make it 3 only. Great. Thank you guys for watching. If you like this video, make sure you subscribe our channel, and see you next time.